This recording is showing a web application developed in Golang and leveraging AngularJS. I developed this application to share best practices like exposing the features through a REST API or keeping the web server outside of the data path. It's also a way to show some ECS unique capabilities like the Active Directory self-service API, metadata search, and the ability to apply retentions to objects. First of all, an ECS namespace must be configured to allow users of a specific Active Directory group to create their Amazon S3 credentials through the ECS management API. When we log into the web application using the Active Directory user in the Active Directory group, a corresponding ECS object user is created by the web server. The first thing to do is to create a bucket to store our pictures. The web server returns the course configuration used to create the bucket. Cross-origin resource sharing, CORS, is a mechanism that allows restricted resources on a web page to be requested from another domain outside the domain from which the resource originated. This is necessary to let the web browser send requests directly to ECS. Then we can upload the picture and see that the web server sends to the web browser the necessary headers to upload the picture to ECS. This includes the signature computed using the secret key of the ECS object user. So the web server is not in the data path. After that, we can upload another picture, but this time we indicate a retention and we can see that the web server has the corresponding header. When a picture is selected, some JavaScript code is used to extract EXIF metadata, like the GPS location when the picture has been taken. When we click on search without indicating any parameter, the locations where the pictures have been taken are displayed on the map. Using the pictures tab, we can see the pictures. The URL displayed below the picture shows that the picture has been downloaded directly from ECS. Again, the web server is not in the data path. If we try to delete the picture under retention, we receive the expected error message. We can now indicate a parameter like the width to see the benefits of the ECS metadata search feature. We can also modify the area on the map to search pictures based on the GPS coordinates. If you follow the best practices and leverage the ECS S3 extensions, it makes an application more scalable because the web server is not in the data path, and it makes an application easier to maintain because there's no database involved. And don't forget to leverage the other unique ECS capabilities, like the ability to access the object through NFS and HDFS.